pinstriped suits, short hair, and fedoras are all staples of the 1920s. A major change was taking place in America, one that affected technology, society, and yes, fashion. In the late 1800s, Victorian fashion was the norm. Women wore long, uncomfortable dresses with tight, painful corsets. Men wore sake suits, which were very ill-fitting. The sleeves were too short and the pants too tight. But after the First World War, things began rapidly progressing. Women won the right to vote, alcohol was banned, and more people, men and women, were working. This heavily influenced American fashion. Speakeasies at nightclubs were extremely popular and were a new opportunity for people to get dressed up. Women needed something more comfortable to wear while they worked and something that would allow them to embrace their sexuality. The general trend for women's dresses was that the hemlines went up while the waistlines went down. Before 1925, most dresses stayed well below the knee, but continued to rise as the decade came to an end. The waistlines went down to the hips, creating a loose and flowy design. Most day dresses were also very colorful and floral. New and popular dresses included Nile green, sunset orange, French blue, and maize. Evening dresses had a similar design, but were made of more expensive material and beading. The popularity of evening dresses led to the rise of fashion designers, who became wildly famous during the 20s and are still remembered today. People like Coco Chanel, Madame Prime, Jean Patou, and Paul Poiré were looked up to by men and women alike. They became some of the first celebrities, along with actors like Charlie Chaplin and Rudolph Valentino. Another women's clothing trend was the cloche hat. Cloche, meaning bell in French, was given its name for its shape. It was very popular with women for its comfort and practical uses. It allowed women to tuck their hair into it and gave them a breezy, carefree look.